The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.
Hi, I'm Karen Signoracci. For over 20 years, I've devoted my career to helping nonprofits reach their goals, increase their funding, broaden their donor base, and their community outreach. In addition, I work with my nonprofit clients to get the right people around the table to serve and execute the mission of the organization for its betterment and its service to the community. If you're considering starting a nonprofit, serve on a nonprofit board of directors, or are currently struggling to get your organization to the next level, please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. Let me know how I can help you increase your efficiency. One of the key components to a successful nonprofit are its board of directors. They are integral to the success by setting strategy, vision, and taking on fiduciary responsibility. Making key decisions is also part of this role. Please visit KarenSCS.com. That's KarenSCS.com. And let's speak about making your nonprofit and your vision. Hello, hello, and welcome. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci. I've spent the last 20 years working with nonprofits, raising money, community outreach, some family foundations, board development, and I always like to start the show by just giving my little PSA. There's so much good work being done on Long Island. There's so many amazing nonprofits right here in our own community. Think about what you can do, what you'd like to do, whether it's your family, your place of business, your block, your community. There's so much need and there's so much good work. And it doesn't have to be a big boatload of money. It could be a donation of books. It could be coats. It could be scarves. It could be diapers and wipes. So if you have need any ideas, you can always check out my website. I have a couple of things listed there, and you can send me an email, and it's KarenSCS.com. So today I am thrilled. I have a guest, and we are going to talk about money. We're going to talk about all good things. Bobby D. Ehlert. Hello and welcome, Bobby.
Hey, Karen. Thanks for having me.
You are welcome. We're going to get into Inspiring Hearts and what you do. But before we do that, especially at this time of lovely eating and enjoying and all kinds of food and desserts, have you made anything at home recently or eaten anywhere recently you care to share with us?
Well, I'm always a at-home cook and kind of a foodie at home, and I'm trying to inspire my two little boys to be cooks as well. And of course, your holiday season, you know, they're like, okay, let's do some cookies. I'm like, okay, what kind of cookies you want to make? We're going to make peanut butter cookies with the fork, you know, marks on the...
Terrific.
Yep, got to do those.
Classic.
And then the oldest is like, you know what? I just really want chocolate chip cookies. So I was like, okay, let's do some chocolate chip cookies. My wife's gluten-free, so we use the almond flour and all the stuff. And I just like them better. They taste so much better, especially if you... Here's the tip. You got to leave it in the fridge overnight and then make the cookies the next day.
Okay. Good tip. Okay.
Yeah.
So the cookie palooza was a success?
They're gone, so we have to do another batch now.
Oh, well, then that's accomplishments right there.
That's right.
That's good. Full bellies with cookies. Love it. So we met through a client.
Yes, we did.
And I was immediately... impressed with your vast knowledge of not just what you do specifically, but the whole nonprofit spectrum. Mm-hmm. And your work with boards of directors, executive directors. And so tell us about Inspiring Hearts Fundraising. What's your mission? What's your tagline? And I need you to bring it all together, because you do kind of pull it all in together.
For sure. So I'll kind of start where we're at here and just run backwards really, really, really fast. So Inspire Hearts Fundraising has been around, you know, now 5-6 years. We are the only, what I call paddle raise only firm in the nation. And when I say that, we work with nonprofits and help them with their galas and their golf tournaments, any special events that they have. And we help them to maximize the revenue there. We kind of like to say that we inspire hearts of donors to help them fund your mission. And that's what it's all about, because the fundraising is the fuel that makes the mission happen. No money,
absolutely
no mission. So we work with, again, nonprofits to strategize their events. And then myself, my wife, anyone on our team, then we are the ambassadors. We are the fundraisers. We are the MCs, sometimes called an onstage development director, at the event. And we're able to go up there and we're able to help tell the story, able to make the pitch, make the big ask, everyone, get those paddles together. Let's do something amazing with this community and let's do something magical here. So that's where we're at now. But rewind 7 years, Aaron and I met and we were both auctioneers. We're both multi-generational auctioneers. Her mom's an auctioneer. Her grandpa was an auctioneer. So she's third generation. I'm second generation auctioneer. My mom's an auctioneer. My stepdad's an auctioneer. My two brothers were auctioneers.
Wow.
Yes. So we were in the auction world. I came from the automobile auction world and was selling cars really fast. $25,000, $26,000, $27,000, $28,000, $29,000, $30,000. So I was doing that, selling used cars to used car dealers. Wait, no, that does not give me the warm and fuzzies. I need something bigger. And I was doing a lot of work with nonprofits. Light bulb went off one day. I was like, I'm doing that forever. Erin, my wife, she started, her mom was in the machinery and kind of equipment business, liquidating, and was kind of gross and kind of dirty. And she's like, yeah, mom, I'm going to do what you do. She'd be like, but you don't want to be an auctioneer. She's like, but I'm going to do these fancy galas. I'm going to get dressed up. I'm going to wear great shoes. I'm going to have great fashion, and I'm going to help nonprofits raise a lot of money.
She does just that.
And she was one of the kind of the trendsetters about 20 years ago and got into this. So then we met and we connected in the sky. We like to say that our stars collided and our hearts combined. And we saw how the evolution of nonprofit galas was moving away from auctions, which is transactional giving, to more philanthropic giving, transformational giving. And we saw that there's organizations that just want to do the paddle raise. They just want to do the live ask, you know, the big pitch, the cash call, whatever that might be. And we've taken all of our knowledge of, you know, almost 40 years of combined fundraising. We're like, okay, there's going to be a better way of fundraising at events. And so far, it's been amazing. We've been seeing such great participation. There's a great buyer confidence coming back with the donors.
You know, I always ask people, you know, how they got to the nonprofit world, because it's a very twisty, turny world and road. And not everybody sets out to go into nonprofit, whether it's fundraising or social work. And you are another example of that. And Aaron, too, was you really had, you know, a different professional path, but then something called you because you wanted the emotional connection and you wanted to feel you could give back. And there's so many business-minded people that the nonprofit world needs.
Absolutely.
And that ties me into the second thing I want to talk about is, you know, you're not just showing up the day of that auction.
Right.
Let's raise some money. Who's in the room? Okay, great. What time you want us on the stage? It's not transactional at all. That would be transactional.
That would be.
So you, months before.
Yeah, sometimes a year before.
Sometimes a year out. So you might be working right now on something for next December.
Absolutely am.
And you are having a conversation with the staff.
Yes.
The board members?
Yes.
The event planner?
Yep.
And you are really creating a theme, a message. And so people are sitting there and they're not just hearing this transaction.
Yes.
They're hearing the story. And I always say about events, because I have to go to a lot of them and I enjoy going to a fair number of them too, is that you want people to get in their car afterwards and say, I know why I was here. And I want to come back next year.
That's absolutely it.
And what have you found is, you know, one of the things that you really focus on in that prep? Because the prep is important.
Well, a lot of it is timing within the event. And it's been a misconception over many, many years that we're going to do the program, we're going to do the honorees, we're going to, you know, talk about the sponsors, and we're going to do all of those things. And then at the end of the night, we're going to do the fundraising. When everybody's had a little bit too much to drink, maybe some people have had to go home because babysitter time ran out, whatnot. And people, you know, nonprofits were scared to fundraise. And they were like, well, let's just do it at the end and see what's left over. But we're saying fundraise first. Let's get that, you know, let's do that right away. Let's build that inspirational moment, what I like to call the golden goosebump moment, where everyone's on the edge of their seats. They're like, okay, this mission and this organization is so great. They're helping people and they're making a great impact in the world. How do I be involved? And they're on the edge of their seats and they've got the goosebumps. It's like, all right, friends, now's that time you're able to join us, align with us, you know, make that investment, make that donation and raise that paddle. So that's what we really like to focus on is looking at the event as a whole and identifying where that moment is and then building that inspiration and building that motivation and getting to that philanthropic crescendo to say, all right, friends, let's do this. Let's make it happen. And it happens early.
It happens early. And you don't want to lose people to looking at raffles. Again, babysitter, maybe they're double booked. Maybe they're coming straight from work and they've had a long day. Yeah. You know, I think the other interesting thing that you bring up, and I know you've brought this up in some of our conversations, is that the onus is not only on you and the one staff member or two staff people. You involve the board.
Absolutely.
And they're to be ambassadors.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Whenever like future clients or potential clients ask me, they're like, well, Bobby, what makes a successful gala? I was like, well, there's lots of ingredients with that, but the number one thing is an engaged board. And when the board is engaged within the fundraising at the event, but most importantly, before and following the event, and they see the role that they can play within that, the influence that they play, they're able to provide things that are more valuable than dollars. A lot of times board members think they're just checkbooks, and they're not. They have such leadership within them. They have such influence, and they've got a lot that they can play.
Well, it's more than just bringing a table or bringing your family or bringing whoever you're bringing. It's the engagement.
Yes.
And, you know, we're going to continue with the board members and the full package of the events. And we're going to talk about some other things that maybe if you're sitting at an event, you might think differently next year, next time. So this is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci, and we'll be right back. And welcome back. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci, and my guest today is Bobby D. Ehlert. We are talking about inspiring hearts. We're talking about fundraising and auctions. Bobby, we've already covered a lot.
We have.
And we've talked about how you got started, your career, and Inspiring Hearts Fundraising. How can people find you? What is the website?
Well, very easy. Inspirehearts.com. Mm-hmm. You can find us there, but we're also LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, all of the things. We also have a podcast where we get to dive deep into the type of conversation that we're having. It's called Heart of the Gala, and you can find it anywhere that podcasts are available.
Terrific. Heart of the Gala. I like it. Speaking of galas, we were just talking about two things we're going to continue on here. We were talking about nonprofit boards
yes.
and keeping them engaged. And I do a lot of board training, and I work with so many wonderful people that are on a nonprofit board. And sometimes they need a little zhuzhing. They need a little encouragement. So their job is not just to bring guests and help fill the room. Yeah. Maybe they are there to greet.
Yeah, as a host.
Hosts, to greet fellow attendees. They are there maybe to do a little pumping up.
Yeah. They've got such energy. And when that energy is brought into the room, that energy can build more energy. And the board members, they really can help with that.
And the board members, they know the inner workings, good, bad, and ugly. They know that the organization needs this money.
Yes.
But they also know that I always, you know, akin to the Girl Scouts, make new friends and keep the old.
Yeah.
So you're sitting there as a board member and you say, you know, there's a couple over there. I don't know them. Maybe they can be a new friend
right.
to our work and mission. And I think, you know, when we worked together on our mutual client, that was one of the things I learned from you. Was how much the it's almost like coaching. You can't coach the kid while you're playing the game.
Right.
But before the game you coach and after the game you coach. And so that's part of what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I feel like maybe some board members, because they are very active on Long Island, perhaps, maybe they're on one or two boards, whatever the case may be. You know, what if they say to you, well, Bobby, why are we having this event in April? Or why are we having it on a Thursday? You know, what advice do you give people? Because truthfully, you and I both know, and I know you travel a fair amount too. If we wanted to, almost every night or every week, we could be at a nonprofit event.
Yes, pretty much absolutely every night.
We could.
And when we talk to board members and leadership of nonprofits, it really comes down to attention and competition. Mm-hmm. And there's so many different events that are out there, and there's so many different styles of things. And it's really identifying what's going to be best for your donors and your potential donors to get them in the door, get them to your gala, get them to your event. And here on Long Island, I mean, do you know how many nonprofits are on Long Island?
The number a few years back was somewhere around 6,000.
Okay. So there's 6,000.
And that includes, you know, Rotary Clubs, Service Clubs. It includes some larger hospitals. You know, it's a big gamut.
Right, right. Even if it was 10%, that's 600, that you could have two a night for an entire year.
Correct.
And that's a lot of competition. Competition for your donors, competition for your sponsors, competition for the dollars that you're trying to raise. So it's identifying where in the year is going to be your place. Where can you own that night and that place where, like, everyone starts to see, okay, that's the night of XYZ organization's gala. I have to go to that.
And I think a lot of people think that way. You know, mm-hmm. they know the second Thursday of May, we go to this event.
That's right.
We go every year.
Yeah, yeah. The first Monday in May, the big Met Gala. That's like a big part of their brand.
That is a big part. Well, it's branding.
It is.
That's exactly it. It comes back to that. So tell us, you know, I'm sure you have met so many people.
Yes.
I'm sure you have been really captivated by emotion.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure maybe there's been a video that's been shown maybe before you went on or after, and then you're like, okay.
Many times.
What has been, and you have a business mindset too. You have a strategic mind, and I've seen it at work. But what would you say has been your proudest moment? You know, Oprah always said she had her aha moment. What has been your aha moment?
My aha moment was I was working with an organization that grants wishes for children with, you know, terminal diseases and their families. And at the end of the event, it was a great event, lots of auction action, lots of paddles in the air. The executive director came up and said, Bobby, this is the work that you're doing is absolutely amazing. I'm like, what did I just do? I just had a great time and I helped raise some money. She's like, well, because of you, we can now grant 12 more wishes. And that's when the light bulb went off. And I'm like, you mean I get to do what I do that I'm really, really, really good at and I'm passionate about and I have a lot of fun within, and I get to directly impact an organization and the impact that they have in the world? I was like, yes, that's what I'm going to do. So I get to hear that and I get to, you know, feel that each and every day after all the events that I get to do.
And that stays with you.
Oh, it does. I mean, my heart is so full at the end of the night. I sleep very, very well.
It's funny. You probably sleep really well, but then there's like that little bit of a high too.
Oh yeah. It's the best drug. You can't shoot it, snort it, drink it, or anything. You at the event, when a room comes together, there's this magical electricity that's combined and the vibration in that room just goes up. And then once it's done, there's this just celebration of what this room has accomplished together. We've raised a lot of money and now we're able to, you know, go out and help our community directly. And it's that combination of love in the room is it does create that high that you just can't get it anywhere else.
No, you can't. And it really, I always say, you know, my favorite thing is people.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, I'm lucky and you are too. Yeah. We get to deal with people.
Absolutely.
All day. So if there are some people out there on Long Island listening right now and maybe, you know, the first Monday of May, they go to the same event or maybe they're gearing up for something as a committee member, what would you say to them as they're sitting in their seats as an attendee to get them to think a little bit differently? And if there's an auction about to take place or a video, not to pull out their phone
right. And
be tempted to be distracted. You know, what would you tell them as they're sitting there in that moment?
Be in the moment. This is a very special time where there's a collection of humans that are coming together to do great things. And be in that moment. Be aware of the surroundings of what's going on. Be aware of what the story is being told. Mm-hmm. And then this is a big coaching tip for board members. It's like, when it's time to be quiet, it's time to be quiet. But when it's time to clap and cheer, you'll be involved within that. Be there, because that's a very special thing. We can get distracted in all of the things that are around us, but that is so special to be there with that collective experience that we're all sharing, and we're focused at this one point with one goal to raise as much money as we can.
I like it. And I like to say to people, be where your feet are.
Yeah.
So be right there and be present. Now, on the flip side of that, if any of our friends or colleagues or business professionals out there that are listening that work in the nonprofit space, maybe they're an executive director, maybe they're a CEO, maybe they're an event planner, what would you say to them?
Well, and for them, it's, again, being a part of that moment and not be, don't get lost in the weeds. Don't get lost in all the specifics and all the other, you know, things that are going on. It's like, here, we're here. And when a donor raises their paddle, go love them. It's okay to run over, tell them thank you, give them a big hug.
That's great advice.
Celebrate, you know, what is happening there. And there are events that sometimes fall short of what their goals are, but it's still to be celebratory of what has happened. I mean, it takes a lot of energy, time, blood, sweat, and tears to put on the event.
Mm-hmm.
The success beyond that is not always the dollars that are raised in the room that night. It's the relationships that it created. It's those connections that can then post-event really foster and grow into some amazing things. And support, dollars, time, talent, treasure, all the things.
I agree with you. And I think if an event can carry 10 or 12 or maybe even 15 people afterwards for a major gift, maybe to be on the committee, maybe to be on the board, maybe to just get involved.
Right.
And like I've said before, and maybe you've seen this, it isn't always money. Sometimes it is things.
Yeah.
Tangible things.
Yep.
That people in the community just need, that they just need. And sometimes people feel like, hey, that's a little bit easier for me right now, or that's a good entree in.
Right.
Let me get a bag of diapers.
Something.
Or some pajamas, donated. And that helps too. Do you feel that some of the events, they stay with people for weeks, months, years, you want them to stick?
If they're good. If they're not good, they will hear about it, but they will rapidly forget about it, because then they're going to go to something that else is good. But if there's an event that's truly inspiring for them and it moves them to take action on the night of and move beyond that, then it will live forever in their hearts and in their minds. It's not what they do, it's how they feel.
It's how they feel. So one more time, the website for people to reach you.
Inspirehearts.com.
And also the podcast.
Heart of the Gala.
Bobby, I'm so grateful for your time.
Thank you so much for having me. And thank you for all the work that you're doing to help our community here on Long Island.
Well, I thank you also. And thank you for what you teach and what you inspire and how people feel.
Yeah. We're all in this together.
We are. This is The Big Picture on 103.9 Long Island News Radio. I am your host, Karen Signoracci. Thank you for listening. Just a reminder, you can visit my website, KarenSCS.com, for all of my past shows and some other information. Thank you and have a great day.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management,